everybody. So today I will be sharing with you guys my iOS 14 hacks that I've learned over the past couple of days of using it. And I really enjoy using them, so I thought I'd share with you guys. Let's start off with default browser. With the new update, it allowed you to change the default browser from Safari to Google Chrome, and I'm going to show you just how to do that. If you're like me and you like to use Google Chrome over Safari, then this hack is for you. First, you want to go into your settings and scroll down until you get to Chrome. Once you get to Chrome, you're going to see a place where it says Default Browser App. You're going to click this and change it from Safari into Chrome. And now, whenever you open a link in the app, it'll automatically go to Chrome instead of Safari. Another useful tip is the hide screen feature. And if you don't like using the app library, or you just want to hide your screens that don't match your aesthetic that you have going on, then this hack is for you. All you have to do is hold down your screen until you're into the edit home screen mode. Then tap the bar at the bottom. Then you're going to hold down the check underneath the screen that you want to hide. Once you uncheck it, then it will be hidden once you go back into the home screen. To add it back, all you have to do is go back into the edit home screen mode, click the bottom bar, and then recheck the screen. So if you don't like how your custom app covers make you go to shortcut first, this one is for you. What you can do is create a shortcut widget, but first you need to create a folder of all of the apps that you want on this widget. So to create this folder, all you have to do is go into your shortcuts app and create a new folder by clicking the tab in the top right. Then you're going to name it whatever you want it to be. Then you're going to execute the same steps that I showed you guys in my last video, go check that out. But you're just going to add a new shortcut, search for open app, then choose the app you want it to open. Click the three dots in the top right corner, and then this leads you to rename the app. I advise you to name the app based on whatever app it's going to go to so that you don't get confused. Do this for 4 apps, or 8 if you have a large widget. To go back into your home screen and add this widget to your home screen by going to add in the top right corner, scrolling down until you get to shortcuts, then add a medium widget to your home screen. Now all you have to do is stack widgets on top of it that are cute. Now you have a hidden category of apps on your home screen. Okay guys, this next one is really cool. I'm going to show you guys how to open your phone with just your voice. you're going to want to go to settings, then go to accessibility, scroll down till you see voice control. Now you're going to go to customize commands, custom, create new command. Now put the phrase that you want to say. For me, I'm just going to say wait for it, and if you know, you know. Now for my custom gesture, I am going to put in the password for my phone. Once you're done, you're going to press save and then go back out, then press save again. Then you're going to want to make sure that voice control is toggled on. Now, when you lock your screen, you can say the words and it'll unlock your phone. Wait for it. And opens up my screen. Isn't that so cool? The next hack has to do with your home button. I'm going to show you how to open your phone without having to click the button. So basically, you're going to go to settings, accessibility, scroll down to home button. Then you're going to see rest finger to open, and right now I have it on, but I'm going to show you first what it looks like when it's off. So normally you have to put your finger on the home button to unlock it, and then you have to click it in order to open it. But when rest finger to open is on, all you have to do is lift up your phone and place your finger on the fingerprint, and it'll open up your phone for you. I think this makes older phones feel more like newer phones because you don't have to click the button in order to open it. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Don't forget to check out my last iOS 14 video and look out for more videos coming soon. Bye!